This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. We find ourselves once again at the intersection of art and science. Today we're talking about science ink with a K. That is the tattoos of the science obsessed. For that conversation, we're joined by Carl Zimmer. He's the author of a new book with the same name. So, Carl, thanks for being with us. This started out with a pool party where you saw a geeky tattoo?
Yeah, I happened to see a friend of mine who is a neuroscientist at Harvard, and I saw that he had a DNA tattoo on his shoulder, and I complimented him on it. It made sense. He's a neuroscientist. He studies how genes act in the brain. But then he explained to me how actually there was this much deeper meaning, namely that he had inscribed, encoded his wife's initials in the DNA on his shoulder. And so I could see that this was a real expression of geek love. And I started to wonder if there are other tattoos out there on scientists that I just didn't know about.
Well, people have sent you hundreds of images of these science tattoos. And what's fascinating about your book is that you're actually able to dive into the science behind them and the deeper meaning of why these people chose them. So let's go through a couple. We've got one of Darwin's finches. It's actually quite beautiful.
It is very lovely, yes. So when Charles Darwin was a young man, he got the opportunity to travel around the world, and he ended up in the Galapagos Islands, where he collected some birds. He thought there were a lot of different kinds of species, maybe mockingbirds and wrens and all sorts of different things. And then when he brought them back to England, he was amazed to discover that these very different-looking birds were actually all finches. So they were very similar in some ways, but they looked very different. And this got him thinking about how you could get all this diversity just on a little group of islands. And it helped to give rise to the whole theory of evolution. And so as an homage to that incredible insight, actually several different scientists sent me tattoos of Darwin's finches. So they really have an iconic place in the history of science.
So, and you also have one of an individual who's taken, what was it, Edison's patent for the phonograph on his arm?
Yeah, this was a musician who discovered this patent drawing that Edison had filed. I mean, you have to, when you make a new invention, you have to file a drawing, and these are actually quite beautiful drawings. At the time, they were engravings, and so it was a way of him sort of expressing his love for this really amazing piece of technology. In the book, I write about what it was like when Edison first created it, the first phonograph, and then started playing it for people. I mean, Edison himself couldn't believe it. His assistants couldn't believe that this thing worked. And he brought it to New York to bring to magazine editors, and they were astonished as well. This was a miracle. You could capture voice. Who would have ever thought you could do that?
So what's the primary reason that most of these science enthusiasts, why this form of expression of their passion?
For a lot of these scientists, the things that they're studying really become a part of themselves. I mean, think about it. You become a biochemist, and maybe there's one molecule that you're going to study day in and day out. You are just studying it all the time. And so it's so much a part of you that you want to actually put it on your skin. And so, you know, it shows just how passionate scientists can be about their science.
So this isn't just a coffee table art book of tattoos from scientists and about science. You really dive into the science here and give us a little bit of the history and the background. What was that process like?
This was really an amazing learning experience for me. I mean, I've been writing about science for quite a while, and yet people would send me images, and I'd look at them and say, I don't really know what this is. And so basically I would get in touch with a scientist and say, explain this to me. What is this? Why did you get this? And then I would start going off and doing my own research. So for example, there's a scientist who sent me a tattoo of a particular kind of neuron that's in our eyes. It catches light, but we're not conscious of the light that it catches. So totally blind people can actually be taking in light through their eyes and not know it. It actually controls how we sleep and things like that. I had no idea that this kind of neuron existed, and it's totally fascinating, and it's actually very important for our biology. And it took a tattoo for me to become aware of it, so it was quite an experience.
Okay, and bonus round for our online viewers. You have a tapeworm named after you. Explain.
Yes, Acanthobacterium zimmeri is my tapeworm. It's a tapeworm that lives inside of stingrays in the Pacific. And the reason for that is that I wrote a whole book about parasites and basically writing about how magnificent and intriguing and important they are. It's called Parasite Rex. And there was a college student who was trying to figure out what she was going to do with her life. Her name is Carrie Filer. And she was rather fond of parasites, and she read my book, and then that gave her the confidence to go and become a parasitologist, which she is today. And as part of her PhD, she had to describe some new species of tapeworms, and so she decided to name one after me, for which I'm very honored.
So please tell me that that is not going to be the tattoo that you get if you choose to get a science tattoo.
No, I will probably encode my wife's name in DNA. I think that's the way to go.
All right. Carl Zimmer, thanks so much for joining us. The book is called Science, Inc. You can find excerpts of it online, and we'll have a little slideshow as well. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us. So, and you also have one of an individual who's taken, what was it, Edison's patent for the phonograph on his arm?
Yeah, this was a musician who discovered this patent drawing that Edison had filed. I mean, you have to, when you make a new invention, you have to file a drawing, and these are actually quite beautiful drawings. They're, at the time, they were engravings. And so it was a way of him sort of expressing his love for this really amazing piece of technology. In the book, I write about what it was like when Edison first created it, the first phonograph, and then started playing it for people. I mean, Edison himself couldn't believe it. His assistants couldn't believe that this thing worked. And he brought it to New York to bring to magazine editors, and they were astonished as well. This was a miracle. You could capture voice. Who would have ever thought you could do that?
Okay, so I can understand Darwin's finches. It looks like a beautiful flower with four birds kind of pointing towards the center. But what about the more esoteric ones? Some people have hemoglobin molecules or Occam's razor tattooed on their bodies.
Yeah, you know, some of these things are not just there for simple aesthetics. They're pretty complicated. So Occam's razor, for example, is actually a philosophical statement. Basically, it says that when you come up with an explanation, it should be as simple as possible, basically. And that is a guiding principle for all the sciences. And so there was actually someone who sent me a tattoo of Occam's razor in Latin going along the side of his body. It was pretty amazing. There are lots of tattoos of you mentioned hemoglobin, and there are lots of other molecules that people have on their bodies, whether it's LSD or caffeine or serotonin, all sorts of different molecules. Chemistry seems to be a pretty easy thing to put on your skin, and you can say a lot with it. The history of LSD alone is worth a whole book.